Good morning, myself Prahalad Bhatkar. This is the first video on gauge trains. Okay, the purpose of the gauge trains, what is the meaning of the gauge train means, it is a combination of the gauges used to transmit the motion from one shock to another shock. Okay, we can transmit the motion also, we can transmit the power also. Okay, that is the same. Then in this case, gauge trains, we'll find a different types of the gauge trains. First one is a simple gauge train. Second is a compound gauge train. Third is a reverted gauge train. Fourth is a planetary gauge train. One more name is for that is a planetary also, that is called it as a epicyclic gauge train. Okay, I will explain one by one. Okay, then in simple gauge train, one gear on each shaft. Then the purpose of the simple gauge train is, we can use the direction, that is a change the direction of the rotation of the gear. Okay, we can use the change the direction of the rotation of the gear. Look at this figure. I have drawn a simple gauge train. I have taken as a four gears, 1, 2, 3, 4. I have written as a four. This is a, I have shown a direction also using a black marker. That is a, this is anti-clockwise, this is a clockwise, this is anti-clockwise, this is a clockwise. In that case, I have taken as a n is the speed of the gear. I have taken in the form of radian per minute, that is RPM. T is the number of teeth on the gauge. Okay, then I will find the velocity ratio for this one. Okay, first I will take it as a, this is the one as a driver, two becomes a driven. I have taken as a velocity ratio for the gear 1 and 2. Okay, for the gear 1 it becomes a driver, 2 becomes a driven. I have taken as a this ratio. This is the ratio is, that is the speed of the, it is the ratio of the speed of the driven gear to the driver gear. Okay, that is the N2 by N1. One is a subscript, that is a for the, I have taken, these are the subscript for 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, that is the N is nothing but a speed of the gear 1, 2 is the speed of the gear 2, T1 is the number of teeth on the gear 1, T2 is the number of teeth on the gear 2, same concept. Okay, then for this is the ratio for the first and second gear, and this is the second, this is the N2, that is the N3 by N2 equal to T2 by T3. This is the velocity ratio for the 2 and 3. In that case, 2 becomes a driver when you consider 2 and 3. When you come to the 3 and 4, 3 becomes a driver, 4 becomes a follower or driven. For that, velocity ratio is, I have taken as a N3, that is the N4 by N3 equal to T3 by T4. Okay, then all the three equations, this is a 1, 2, 1, 2, you multiply, then we will get it as in this way, N2 by N1 into N2, N3 by N2 into N4 by N3 equal to T1 by T2 into T2 by T3, T3 by T4. Then look at this one, N1, this all get cancelled, N2, this also cancel, then N3 also cancel. The remaining is, this comes as the N4 by N1. Here number of teeth, you check it, teeth also it cancels, this also cancels, this also cancels, T3 also cancels, here also cancels. Only remaining thing is, that is the N4 by N1 equal to T1 by T4. That is, we get it as a velocity ratio. I have taken as a V dot R means, that is a velocity ratio. We can make it as a, from this equation, we can make it as a conclusion that, that is, this is a T2, 3, that is a gear 2 and gear 3. It not comes picture in this formula. Look at this one. Number of teeth will not comes into this picture. Speed also not comes into picture related to gear 2 and gear 3. These are the nothing but they will call it as the intermediate gears. One more name is, that is the idle gear as well. That is the idle. The purpose of this one, we can for the change of the direction. Okay. And if it is a distance is more, for the simple gear trains, we can use as a intermediate gear. Look at this. These are not placed at all in the velocity ratio. Gear 2 and gear 3. It not comes into picture at all. Okay. Then gear 1 and, that is the driver, this is first will come, last gear will come into picture. That is a N1, N4 by N1 equal to T1 by T4. Then I will go to the next gear, that is a compound gear train. In compound gear train, in that case, in the case more than one gear on a shaft. Look at this one. I have taken as a plus sign here. This is a plus sign means that is a shaft axis. Look at this one. Then compound gear means in each shaft we will find a more than one gear. Look at this one shaft, the center. That is I have taken as a two gears, gear 2 and gear 3. Okay, on single shaft. Then you have to say that is a compound gear tree. On single shaft, we will find the more than one gear. Okay, this is a simple gear. Look at that, 2, 3. That is a compound gear tree. For this also, we will find the velocity ratio. That is a 192. I have taken as a velocity ratio between 192. 1 becomes a driver, 2 becomes a driven. For that, N2 by N1, T1 by T2. That is a reciprocal. For the gear 3 and 4, that is a N4 by N3, T3 by T4. This is also velocity ratio between 3 and 4. One more thing, in this case, compound gear train, the speed of N2 equal to speed of N3. Okay, that's why you are not finding a velocity ratio between 2 and 3, because both are the same. Because this is a shaft, both gears on single shaft, that's why speed of this N2 equal to N3. Then when come to the multiplication, the finally look at this equation, N2, it comes as a N2 multiplication. You do the multiplication for this one, N2 by N1, N4 by N3, equal to T1 by T2, T3 by T4. Look at this one, the speed of N2 and speed of N3, both are same, that's why both cancel each other. Both cancel each other. The remaining is N4 by N3. The number of teeth, that is a T1 by T2 as it is, into T3 by T4. What the things you can make it? You look at this one. This is a 1. T1 is a, becomes a driver for the 2. When you consider the second, 3 is becomes a driver, 4 becomes a driven. That's why at numerator, the number of teeth on the driving gauge, this is the number of teeth on the driving gauge, divided by number of teeth on driven gauge. Okay, that is the first numerator, it comes as number of teeth on driving gauge, and denominator it comes as a number of teeth on follower of driven gauge. The application, you can find it in lathe machine, in gearbox, to change the velocity ratios. We can find it, the application in gearbox also you can find it. The third is, in this case, you have to remember this one. When it is a shaft, same axis, the speed may be same. That is, the speed should be same. This concept you need it for the solution of the numerical on the gear train. Then I'll come to the third one, that is the reverted gear train. This is also important. What the reverted gear train says, first and last gear are coaxial or same axis. What is the meaning of this one? This is the axis. I have taken as a 4 gear. This is a sectional view. I have taken as a gear 1, gear 2, gear 3, gear 4. I have taken as a radius of the gear 1 is R1. Radius of the gear 2 is R2. Radius of the gear 3 is R3. Radius of the gear 4 is, I have taken as R4. Then, what the things that the first gear, this is, I have taken as the first gear. And last gear is, in this case, you look at the figure, last gear is the fourth one. Gear 1, that is a gear 1, first and last gear, coaxial. Coaxial means same axis. If you look at this one, this is, I have taken as a red, I marked once again, that is a red. Both are the coaxial. Look at this one. Okay. Then, one more thing, if you look at the geometry, this is, look at this, radius of the R1 plus R2. Look at the geometry, R1 plus R2 equal to the radius of R3 plus R4. Okay. Then, one more thing, if the module is same, for the all the gears, same module is there means, that is M equal to D by T, then module, I can write it as a M equal to D, can I can write it as a 2R divided by T. Once again, I will keep it in the form of radius, that comes as a MT by 2. If the gear is, I replace that one. Instead of radius, I keep it in the form of number of teeth, MT by 2, MT 2 divided by 2. This is, I have taken a replacement with respect to R, with respect to MT. Okay. Then, for the same pitch circle, That is the same circular pitch. This is a modulo is same means all cancel. Okay. Then remaining is what? This is the two also cancel. That comes as a T1 plus T2 equal to T3 plus T4. Then one more thing in this case, if the circular pitch, that is a pitch circle radius, what the things it says? Pitch circle of radius of the gear is directly proportional to the number of teeth. You have to remember this one. When it is a modulus thing, this is the application used for the to solve the numerical problems of the gear train. Okay, you have to remember this one. Pitch circle radius of the gear is directly proportional to number of teeth on the gear. If the module is same, that is the circular pitch. The application of the reverted gear train is you can use for the clock. What is that? Minute. That is a minute dial. That is a minute dial and hour dial. Both are in the same axis. Okay, that is they can use for the clock, and you can use for the lathe back gears also. The application you can find it reverted gear train. Okay. I will stop here only. Okay, if there are any doubt, here also I have taken as a plus one. This is the symbol of the axis of the shaft only. Okay, one is this is a one subscript related to gear one, two subscript related to gear three. I have taken this one. This is a VR means that is the velocity ratio. I have taken as this is a driver and driven. That is the driven. One more name is that is a follower also. These are two, three becomes the intermediate idle also. Okay, I'll stop here only. Thank you.